Hi, I'm Nathan, and in this video, we're going to talk about customer lifetime value, also known as CLV. Businesses prefer retaining customers over acquiring new ones. Ever wondered why? If you speculated the high cost as one of the reasons, then you're right. Businesses are curious to weigh the value of each customer and determine who is truly worth investing in. This is exactly when we use customer lifetime value, to identify the total worth of a customer based on their relationship since it was built with the organization. This means that it calculates the absolute benefit a business will gain from its existing customers over a period of time to achieve higher growth in the business. Customer lifetime value can also forecast the revenue of your company. The healthier the customer base you have, the better the forecast will be. Let's consider a scenario here to better understand the idea of customer lifetime value. Sam visits the nearby cafe every morning, 5 days a week, to grab a cup of coffee worth $9, whereas Peter only makes the same purchase once a week. Sam's lifetime value would be calculated as $45 per week, whereas Peter generates revenue of $9 a week. So in order to calculate the lifetime value of each customer, we simply calculate the annual revenue and multiply it by the average number of years of the retention period. Sounds interesting, right? Another key business metric that helps comprehend the use of customer lifetime value much better is customer acquisition cost. Customer acquisition cost, also known as CAC, calculates the cost and resources incurred in order to onboard a new customer. If acquisition cost exceeds the lifetime value of a customer, it indicates that the customer is not profitable for your business. Let's investigate a scenario to understand this better. A clothing business has many customers. To acquire each customer, the company targeted them by sending free flyers, subscription coupons, offered free delivery, and sent a discount incentive. The total cost accrued in acquiring each customer came down to $50. Let's assume if one of the customers purchased just one basic t-shirt costing $15 and churned after a year. Her lifetime value would be only $15. Now, if you remember, the cost of acquisition was $50. That means the company lost $35. Similarly, the company can calculate the CLV of each customer by considering the acquisition cost and then decide how to target each customer. CLV and CAC are metrics that can boost your business's revenue stream. Here's how. Identify high revenue generating customers, optimize profits, and design loyalty programs to retain them. Focus on improving engagement with low revenue generating customers to identify and serve their needs better. Make informed decisions that are focused on monetizing your marketing efforts. Form a healthy customer base using the CLV metric. Before I wrap this video up, I'd like you to try calculating customer lifetime value in the scenario presented on the screen. Let us know your answers in the comments section below. Don't forget to consider the acquisition cost. Now, can you tell us what the CLV is here? Let us know in the comments below about your experience calculating the customer lifetime value. Share with us if the information helped you focus your marketing efforts towards converting low-impact customers on the path to higher revenue-generating customers. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.
Data Science Dojo. Data science for everyone.